Well, say, I meant to ask you, how was Mrs. Richardson's party the other day?
Oh, it was very nice. She's the most perfect housekeeper I've ever seen. Her house is absolutely immaculate.
Yeah, that's what I understand.
Her table looked just beautiful. Of course, there was a good reason for that.
Well, why not? America's finest silver plate is 1847 Rogers Brothers. America's finest silver plate is 1847 Rogers Brothers. From Hollywood, International Silver Company, creators of 1847 Rogers Brothers Silver Plate, presents The Adventures of Ozzie and Harriet, starring America's favorite young couple, Ozzie Nelson and Harriet Hilliard. Rogers Road. There's David, age 12, and Ricky, age 8, on their hands and knees creeping toward the Davenport. Their faces look so serious. Must be somebody hiding back there. I wonder who it is. Maybe it's Nick, the family dog, or maybe it's little Will Thornberry from next door. Hey, those feet look awful big for... Why, it's Ozzie! Now, what's a full-grown man doing hiding behind the Davenport? Okay, fellas, okay, you caught me. I surrender.
Gee, Pop, you aren't playing right. We're supposed to be the cowboys and you're a bad Indian.
Well, I'm doing the best I can.
You're supposed to show a little fight.
Well, I've been saying bang, bang, but you guys won't fall down.
You've been missing us.
According to the laws of Fort Nelson, you're entitled to a trial. I vote we shoot him.
I vote we shoot him, too.
It was hardly worth getting the judge out of bed for.
Indian, have you any last words?
Yeah, me quit.
You can't quit, Pop.
David, this is the third time you've captured me, and it's the third time I've been sentenced to be shot, and I quit.
Don't quit now, Pop. Let us capture you once more, like the first time when we tied you up.
Well, okay, just once more, though. We Indians have other things to do. This afternoon, I have to pose for a new nickel.
I'll hide here behind this cactus bush.
Which cactus bush?
This one here, with the yellow lampshade on it.
Oh. You know, this time I think I'll surprise you guys and show a little fight. I think it's about time the Indian tied up two rather short cowboys.
That's what I've been saying, Pop. You've been making it too easy. You get him from that side, Ricky. I'll get him from this side.
Grab his feet, David.
Throw the lasso.
No, you don't.
Get the rope.
Ah, a little different this time, isn't it? How do you like this?
You sure are strong, Pop.
You can really fight when you want to.
Thanks, boys. Now untie me and let me up.
Unloosen it over there, Ricky.
Yeah.
That's it. Now you can get up, Pop.
Yeah.
Watch your foot.
Oh, holy smokes.
You really busted it, Pop.
What was that?
Nothing, Harriet. Nothing serious.
I'll see you later, Pop. Come on, Ricky. Ricky?
He's already gone.
Oh, Ozzie, for goodness sakes, my antique vase.
Well, I couldn't help it. I bumped into it accidentally. Besides, antiques are supposed to look old. Certainly looks much older now.
The whole living room looks older. What happened to the scatter rugs?
Oh, they're scattered around.
The place looks like a cyclone hit it.
Oh, Harriet, don't be so fussy.
I don't mind telling you, I'm getting pretty tired of straightening things up around here. The more work I do, the messier the place looks.
Well, suppose it does look a little disorderly now and then. After all, it's a home. People live here.
That's no reason for it to be messed up all the time.
It isn't. Do you know anybody's home that looks nicer than ours?
Yes, I do. Mrs. Richardson's, for one. Her place looks absolutely immaculate all the time.
Well, she doesn't have any children to mess the place up. Don't forget, we have two.
We have three. Here, pick up your Indian hat, Tonto.
Yeah. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.